Welcome to one of the sky islands of Western Ghats, the Kaas plateau. This is a typical laterite plateau in the Western Ghats, where the terrain is flat, seasonality is strong, and floral abundance is spectacular. The Kaas plateau is one of the many biodiversity hotspots in India. Despite covering a small area of just 10 square kilometers, these rocky outcrops support one of the most biodiverse areas within the Western Ghats. The isolation of sky islands, due to the fact that they are present on top of different mountain ranges, combined with the growing urbanization, threaten their diversity even more. These factors make the ecosystem on these high elevation grasslands very fragile. So why haven't we heard about such a region from India, a subcontinent that hosts four biodiversity hotspots? This is because in such ecosystems, grasslands are considered to be just a landscape and do not fit the typical idea of tropical biodiversity, and importance is mostly diverted to forested habitats. The Tropical Ecology and Evolution Lab at IISER Bhopal has focused on changing this by concentrating on three major themes of research within the Kaas plateau. A community study of plant interactions and plant phenology, where we monitor trends in flowering phenologies along with climatic fluctuations, species-specific interactions, and plant-pollinator networks, which will give us insight on the evolution of local ecology and its sustenance. Integrating tourism with outreach to spread awareness about the plateau. Kaas plateau is known for its synchronized, extravagant floral displays. This attracts tourists and improves the economy of this region. On a given day, one can expect up to 50,000 people traversing through the plateau. However, all this tourism is concentrated in the months of September and October, which is the peak flowering season on the plateau. The tourism industry is lucrative enough to persuade people from five neighboring villages to come together to form a joint forest management committee, or JFMC. The JFMC, with the help of the State Forest Department, controls movement of tourists on the plateau and distributes the financial profits among the villagers towards advancement of basic facilities like roads and schools. This floral display-driven tourism encourages local villagers who have migrated to cities to return to their village during the touristy months so that they can support and benefit from the tourism business. In fulfilling our objective of integrating tourism with outreach, we at Tree Lab have developed rapid field guides of the Kaas plateau. These will be sold to the tourists, and the majority of the proceeds will be going to the JFMC. We consider this as one of the success stories from Western Ghats, where due to careful planning, the biodiversity around us is able to engage immediate stakeholders, the villagers, as well as outsiders, the tourists. This shows how plants too are a significant part of our biodiversity, and that flora can be as attractive as the megafauna in Indian tropical ecosystems.